I've reviewed so many tablets, I think I should change my name to Squashy Tablet Review. A lot better than, you know, Squashy Boy. Yo, what is up guys? Welcome back to another video. Today's video is gonna be about the GS4... I got the name wrong. Today's video is gonna be about the XP Pen G64... I almost got it this time. Today's video is gonna be about the XP Pen Star G48... Yeah, I'm doing a review on the Star G640S. This video is not really sponsored by XP Pen. I forgot to turn off my aircon. If you notice in the video, there's like sound in the background. It's my aircon. It's really old and noisy. And I always forget to turn it off when I record videos. So this video will be segmented in a few parts. There'll be the unboxing, the actual tablet review, some gameplay, and my final thoughts. Yes. So with or without further ado, let's get straight into the unboxing.
So here's the box of the XP Pen, it's pretty cool. Inside the box you'll be greeted by the tablet. It uses a micro USB.
ASMR.
My tablet came with this dirt, I don't know what is it, and I can't really wipe it off. Inside the box you'll get a couple of things. The given cable is really, really long. Here's a pen holder that you can stick onto anything. Okay, I got to admit, I really like the pen. I really like the design and it feels really good in the hand. There's nice rubber in the front, which when you rub it, it feels really good. What the? Wait, why is this rubber? Oh my god, rubber feels really good. Oh,
more ASMR.
They gave 20 spare nips. Nice.
So here are some of the specifications of the tablet. It has a 266 polling rate, which is faster than any of the tablets that we have. It has a pressure level of 8,192. Which, I don't think OSU players need pressure level, so you know, it's a plus if you're a drawing artist. Drawing artist? I think all artists draw. Also, 20 spare nips. I don't know why you need so many nips, but you know, nips. Okay, so here's the review of the tablet. So there's some good things and bad things about this tablet, so let's start with the good things. What's good about this tablet is the pen. I really love the pen. The pen is... There's this rubber grip which is made out of this really nice rubber and it helps you grip really well when you're, you know, playing the game. The tablet itself, I like how it can disconnect, you know, the cable can disconnect. Oh yeah, and you can use your mouse on it, like so. It's a really good mouse surface actually. It can replace your mouse pad if you're into that type of things. Okay, let's start with the bad stuff. For one, I really don't like the drivers. Like, I have to put it out there, these drivers are not meant for OSU. There are OSU drivers for XP Pen tablets, but this tablet in particular isn't supported yet. Well, the drivers for this tablet in the XP Pen website has this weird mouse drift thing. As if like, okay, when you stop the pen at where you want to stop it, it continues on a little bit and then it stops, which is really bad. I don't know why there's tablet pen drift. So the drivers are not really ideal for a hardcore OSU player. So until XP Pen rolls out drivers for OSU for this tablet, I can't really recommend it for hardcore OSU players. On the other hand, for drawing, it has a really nice surface for drawing, so yeah, that's a plus. This video is 1 week late. It was supposed to be uploaded when I was in Korea, and I'm already back from Korea, so here's why it was late. The tablet was catered to drawing people, artists. XP Pen got back to me with an email saying that the internal IC of the G640S has been changed from the G640 and hence there is slightly more latency and it also has different drivers and such. First off, it was National Day for the XP Pen people, so they couldn't reply to my emails. Secondly, they have given me a reason why the tablet has this weird pen drift. So let's picture this weighing scale. One side is for OSU players and the other side is for artists. If the tablet wants to be good for OSU, it has to have really little latency and it has to have very little anti-shake. So when it goes down, this side comes up, artists feel a lot of shake. As an artist, you want as smooth strokes as possible, so you don't really want shake. And if you don't want shake, you have to have anti-shake, which brings OSU to have anti-shake and all these weird feeling drivers. So XP Pen has found a middle ground for OSU players and artists, where the tablet is good for OSU players and artists, but is not the best for both. It's also not the worst. Okay, so let's move on to gameplay. Oh my god, do you see that? Wait! Why did you disconnect? Oh my god, that was a good play as well. Overall, I'll rate this tablet a 6 out of 10. It's a good tablet for drawing, it's a good tablet for basic playing of osu, but if you really are into osu like me, it's quite hard to get used to. Until they roll out the drivers, I still cannot recommend this tablet. Well, but what, there's one tablet by XP Pen which I can highly recommend, is the XP Pen G640. It has really good polling rate, response time, hover distance, and also it has dedicated osu drivers, so it's the best XP Pen tablet that you can buy. Other than that, this new iteration of the G640S, it's in a weird spot where I can't really recommend it to any osu player. With that said, thank you so much for watching this video. Like the video if you found it useful, dislike the video if you don't like me. Share this video with your friends who want to buy this tablet, and I'll see y'all in another video.